I have an update on the Tesla coil I built, which I showed in one of my previous videos. A link to that video is up there. Since that video discusses and analyzes the circuit and diagnoses non-working Tesla coils, I won't cover that here. Since my Tesla coil didn't work, I put it aside for a while. But a few days ago, I tried again, and now it finally works. Even though the 2222 transistor I used passed every test I gave it, proving it was good, I guess it wasn't good enough. I used a different 2222 this time, and now it works. This one is an MPS 2222A. Transistors of the same model from different manufacturers can have slightly different properties, especially if they are different versions within the same family, such as 2222 versus 2222A. Even transistors of the same model, version, and manufacturer can have different properties, such as beta. A transistor's beta, also known as HFE, is its forward current gain. So I guess it is possible that the old transistor could have been good, but still not work in this Tesla coil. Therefore, if your Tesla coil isn't working, try another transistor. To prove the bulb isn't being powered by an AC outlet, I've tried to fully show the screw base whenever possible. My coil probably isn't as powerful as it could be, which is why some parts of the bulb aren't as easily lit. This is because there were many things I tried in attempts to get it to work. For instance, when I first wound the secondary coil, I ran out of room, so I overlapped many turns at the top so there would be as many turns as possible. You're supposed to avoid overlapping, but I figured that since the transformer coil is overlapped many times, overlapping should be okay and preferable to not having enough turns. But since it didn't work, I reluctantly decided to cut off the overlapped turns, but that didn't help. So now the number of turns is less than ideal. I also changed the number of turns of the primary a few times. I bet the other secondary coils I created would also work now. I could try to improve my Tesla coil, but at this point, I'm happy it works, and that's good enough for me. By the way, the LED doesn't seem to dim as much, if at all, when my hand gets near. And the transistor now gets warm when the circuit is on. By the way, I didn't violate my goal of only using parts I already had. I got the new transistor from a non-working UPS. Here's all the parts I removed from that UPS. Optocouplers, voltage regulators, diodes, fuses, relays, N-channel MOSFETs, LEDs, thyristor surge suppressor, capacitor, push button, and a buzzer, and of course the 2222 transistors. My Tesla coil didn't cost me anything, except maybe a peaceful mind. Of course, I don't think the parts would have cost much, but it is nice to already have a good collection of parts available on hand so you can create a circuit spur of the moment instead of waiting for parts to be delivered, or even to just test your MacGyver skills by using whatever is available. At the risk of being a downer, I feel the need to point out the potential dangers in case you haven't seen this warning in my previous Tesla coil video. This mostly applies to more powerful Tesla coils, though this circuit could possibly be dangerous in certain situations. There's another update. I modified the raytraced animation depicting how to wire up the primary. Here's the improved version. Here's a different view. I meant to improve the raytraced animation of how to test a transistor using a multimeter, but at the time of making this video, I haven't gotten around to it. These are just purely cosmetic changes, so to speak, not changes in information. Please subscribe, like, share, comment, etc. And if you click subscribe, click the bell to receive notifications of future videos. Even if you click the bell, still check back from time to time, since YouTube doesn't always notify subscribers.